Kaniji Wagwan, one and all. I've been asked to show you how to differentiate the arctangent of x. That's the inverse of the tangent function. Now, it may be that you've remembered the standard derivative for the arctangent of x. If not, we're going to need to differentiate it. You probably don't know how to differentiate the arctangent of x. So let's turn that into something you do know how to differentiate. X clearly equals the tangent of y. Now that's a function you do know how to differentiate, but it is a function in terms of y. So when we differentiate, we're differentiating x with respect to y. The derivative of the tangent is the secant squared of y. Now of course if we want the derivative of this function, we're looking to find dy by dx, not dx by dy. But we can see a standard result, we can flip this round however you want to think about it. Dy by dx clearly is going to equal 1 over dx by dy. If you divide by a fraction, you know that you flip that fraction on the bottom. So that's a pretty obvious result. So basically we've now got what dy by dx is. Dy by dx equals 1 over the secant squared of y. That is the derivative. The only problem here is normally when you differentiate a function of x, you'd expect the derivative to be in terms of x, and it's not. It's in terms of y. So what I'm going to do is show you how to turn this back into a function in terms of x. Now to do this, I need an identity that's going to turn the secant squared back to the tangent squared. Now if you're anything like me, you're rubbish at remembering identities. I'm sure you're not rubbish, I'm sure you're awesome. I'm not. One of the only identities I can ever remember is the cosine squared of something plus the sine squared of something is 1. It's a really important identity to remember. Now, if I want to create secant squared, that's 1 over cos squared, cosine squared, so I need to divide. Now, I can't just divide one thing. Obviously, I have to divide everything by cosine squared theta. You can do that. That, of course, gives me 1 plus, well, sine squared over cosine squared is the tangent squared, and 1 over cosine squared is the secant squared. That's what I was trying to generate. So I can then use this identity to turn this back into the tangent of something. So just doing so gives me dy by dx equals 1 over, and instead of secant squared of y, it's 1 plus the tangent squared of y. Now, I've changed screen, but if you look back at your notes, you'll see that we started off with y equals the arctangent of x. That's what we were trying to differentiate. And the next line we wrote was that x equals the tangent of y. Now, what you might say, but I've got the tangent squared of y. Well, that's easily done. X squared must equal the tangent squared of y. So, summing that back in, I can see that dy by dx equals 1 over 1 plus x squared. And if you can, that's a great standard result, a useful derivative to remember. If you can't remember that, then you'll have to remember this process. That's how you differentiate the arctangent of x. Serena asked me for this video. Hey Serena, how are you? Hope you're well. I don't know why I'm asking that on a video, I do apologise. But if anyone watching this wants videos made for them, go to my website, mathormaths.com, and get in touch with me via Twitter or Facebook. I just want to help everyone be awesome at maths. So, good luck.